now, if you're wondering what all of us ladies are doing on the set today, we are here to speak about, they are here to speak about shared parenting, as well as having a network and a support system around you when you're a new parent, or if you're not, even if you're not a new parent. And it's always nice to know that someone else is also going through the same problems, the same experiences, the same situations that you have to face every day. And that is what Moms in Colombo is all about. Now, this is a very popular Facebook page that has been running for the past 3 years and co-founded by Amber, and of course ably assisted by Dr. Maya as well. And we are going to speak to you today about, you know, so many different aspects of parenting and why it's important to have this sort of information at your hands when it comes to going about being a parent. But now, Arundhati, if I could ask you, actually, shared parenting seems something more of a Western concept and something that's there in, you know, Western countries more than Sri Lanka. When it comes to Sri Lanka, yes, we rely on our extended family members, maybe. But how do you feel about this concept of asking, you know, maybe complete strangers to give you advice about how you should be parenting your children as well?
I think when you say complete strangers, I will avoid that, because no one will ask advice about your child from a complete stranger. They will look into at least if there's any kind of professionality in that person, mm-hmm. or at least the tag as a mother. I don't think anyone is going to ask a question about their child from a complete stranger. Mm-hmm. But for the question you ask, it's not being the Western culture or the Sri Lankan culture. Right now we have a need of support system because we live very fast-tracked lives, right? Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, mm-hmm. right? So I think asking help is a call for strength from another person without mm-hmm. feeling like we are, you know, burden them with our problems, you know. I think that is a huge hurdle with the parents of asking help, feeling that we are burdening other people with our problems.
But it's all right to ask help, and that's what people have been doing on your page as well, haven't they?
Yes.
And also, let's talk about, you know, the nitty-gritty of it, the credibility of some of the advice that's given. What's the filtering system? Do you have something like that in place as well? You touched on this earlier as well, Maya, but if we go into that in a little more
detail.
Do
you want to take that and give your example?
Yes. I mean, first of all the questions are anonymous.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Right? So, you know, and I'm obviously Amber knows who sent it, but mm-hmm. it's posted anonymously. And even I don't know who's said it. That's a very good point that you've brought up, because if you ask 10 different people how you bring up children, you will definitely get at least 7 different answers.
Okay.
Most of the questions are actually, for example, I'll give you an example if that's okay.
Definitely.
You know, teething problems. So, okay. You know, my child is crying. Any solutions to teething problems? Mm-hmm. And of course, you will get probably 60 different, I tried this and it worked, and I tried that. And sometimes they're actually incorrect. So, for example, one, you know, I think maybe an old-fashioned method was putting bees honey and rubbing it on the gums. Mm-hmm. But we now know that actually that's harmful for babies under the age of 1, because it contains some spores, which is, you know, can make them very sick.
So
if an answer like that comes, mm-hmm. then, I mean, what we would do is I would just look at it and then answer very tactfully, well, actually, you know, this is incorrect.
Correct.
And whenever possible, I would link it with something that is already out there on the net.
I see. Okay,
from a reliable source, mm-hmm. because of mm-hmm. course there's so many things out there that are not reliable.
Mm-hmm.
So that there is that link as well that moms can look into.
And what are the benefits that you've found that all these other parents, they must be sharing their feedback with you as well, Amber, about what they feel about the page and what the benefits that they've got out of it are. So what's the feedback you've been like?
We've had some really positive feedback. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's always nice to have just the fact that we have so many people on board and so many people talk about it. But when people actually personally write to you and say it's been really useful, that's the best kind of endorsement. And we actually put one up at the beginning of the year because it was such a wonderful New Year present, where somebody wrote in and said it was a wonderful page, and she had just moved to Colombo, to Sri Lanka, and she found that she just found so much information on the page, and she was a new mom, mm-hmm. and because she had just moved, she had no support system at all. So just asking questions, mm-hmm. and not even always asking questions, because sometimes you may have the same issues as other parents where you have not really asked the question, but just from other people's answers, you've figured out, you know, what you need to know.
Mm-hmm.
So that was a really nice endorsement, and
it
was very, very special. Yes,
it's a good
we get often.
Mm-hmm. But Now, this is deviating a bit from focusing on the child.
Yeah.
Let's say focusing on the parents or the mom. How important is it for moms to have time for themselves as well? Or what are your opinions on that? I don't think you can start with you and then I'll move down to the, for the ladies.
I really can't tell you what I think.
Just in your opinion.
Everyone needs time for themselves. just because you absorb that role of a mother doesn't mean that you should lose your self-identity. I think most of the entire thing goes wrong when you think you're just a mom and that's all you're supposed to do, right? So it cannot happen like that. We all need some time for ourselves to do what we want. So that is, I think, a main reason why we need a support system, friends, a shoulder to cry on. I mean, even just a listening ear, which make you feel important that someone is actually just going through what they're going through on a daily basis. So I think moms need their own time. So this is why we should like have a system where, you know, parenting, even little things like workshops, sort of thing, like activities for a couple of hours where they can trust someone with their kid.
Definitely. I'm sure that helps as well. Your opinions, Maya?
Yes, I mean, absolutely. You know, we'd all like to have more time for ourselves. And I think now with people having smartphones, you know, sitting there, having a cup of tea and being quiet while the baby is asleep maybe and just looking at your smartphone, looking at the Facebook page, you know, that also it does help. And we do fun things as well. I mean, recently the promotion that you rang with the handbags.
Yes. Let's hear about the handbags. Well, it sounds interesting. If you ever say handbags or shoes to like a group of ladies, ladies that's what you get your head. Like, what? Handbags? So let's hear about it.
Well, the promotion was basically you had to empty your handbag there and then and take a picture and WhatsApp or Facebook messages to us, and we had loads of responses. It was fabulous. It was great fun because and everybody had anonymous names because on Facebook when you put your name in, so actually they were sending it to me and I was posting it for them.
Okay.
So it's all anonymous. So some people had can I say condoms on TV? And they had sort of all kinds of stuff in there, which is really interesting. Just to so it was very much a mom-based thing. Moms in Colombo is very much a mom-based thing. Yes, we do parenting stuff, but we don't do activities for kids. For example, our focus is on moms and to make their lives more fulfilling and more enriching. It's not, and that it could be via their kids or helping them help their kids, but it's not about helping their kids per se.
It's about them being able to help their kids. And make it life easier.
Empowering them to do whatever they need to do.
Definitely,
more than, you know, taking over. So,
but now you're running something that's very safe. And I mean, you said earlier that things can be posted anonymously. Everything is posted anonymously and there's no real information that you don't want to be disseminated, being disseminated. But what when it comes to blogs like this, what are the factors that moms and dads and parents should be aware about? Because some of these may not really be as credible as the blog that you're running and the page that you're running. So what are the important factors to look out for when it comes to getting involved in a blog or a forum of this nature, and what are the things that you should really avoid?
I think it's a question of taking responsibility for the stuff that you put out there, because I think if you don't believe it, you shouldn't say it, first of all. And then secondly, I think you need to check the facts of it, I guess, medically. We try not to post health questions related to medical inquiries because we're just too scared to do it. Because simply because, you know, you might get incorrect information and then people are carried away by that information and it can be dangerous. So we try not to do that. But apart from that, in terms of medical sort of fact and fiction, what do you think?
I mean, people do want help in those areas. So what we do is we try and explain it and as much as possible, but we also then have
a
disclaimer to say, you know, actually if there's a problem here, please go and see your doctor.
And I think we should keep in mind that we are having a layman which we are talking to, so we cannot give very extensive information where they're going to practice by themselves, so it has to be very, you know, done very carefully.
But because they're asking this question, is very the thing is they want to be heard, and when they are heard and their question is answered, they're very keen to kind of take advice from anyone who comes along. So it's very important that they understand that it's not always
but I think medical issues, it's better to deviate to a qualified, professional.
Yeah, of course.
We do, always.
And any information that we're giving out today on the program as well, it's always better to consult a doctor before you take any action when it comes to the safety of and the health of the ones you love. Definitely. But okay, now, hypothetically, let's say, if I was a new parent, I'm not, but if I was, then let's go for things that parents ask you about on a daily basis. Maybe something like play dates between with your children, and you meet up in someone's house, and then you have play dates with your children. What are the questions that crop up about these things on the big website?
The most common questions are on feeding your child, getting your child to sleep through the night, move to their own bed,
preschool,
staying at home. I mean, daycare versus nannies. You know, we ran this really good.
Yeah.
Right in the beginning, we had this series of articles. One was by Maya, and one was by another working mom, and it was about stay-at-home mom versus working mom, and that got a major. There was a very heated debate about.
Where we were going with the arguments, pro and con. There were a lot of pros and cons.
And it's kind of hard to be objective, but you can't be judgmental, because your opinion can't be sort of put out there. It's basically just getting moms to express their opinions pitted against each other. So stuff like that, really.
I think it helps them to understand it's just not providing food and safety when you're a mom or a dad. I think you need to. What they do is, I think it's very helpful for them to understand what a complex role they are leading into as a parent.
And in this day and age, I mean, we're thinking about, you know, Sri Lanka, you asked, and the support system. And of course, I think still compared to the West, Sri Lanka still has a very strong support system. But the issues that we're dealing with now are so different to when our parents were young, you know, in terms of just, for example, TV for babies. I mean, that was unheard of. You know, is it good? Babies with iPads. So, you know, what are the pros and cons of it? So, diapers, you know, should we have diapers? Should we have nappies? So what about the bottles, different types? You know, is it good to bottle feed? Again, so these are questions that maybe your mom actually can't answer
anymore.
Even though you have a strong support system with your mom.
So then it's great to have a few ladies and gents who are also going through the same issues and trying to figure out the same manuals as you as well.
It's about trying to create a balance, isn't it? When you're a mother, when you're that role of a parent, I think all these issues is when you cannot control the balance of your life plus the newcomer. I think that's why it helps them to talk to someone and balance the situation.
And on that note, I mean, let's speak about some of the workshops that you've carried out in Colombo as well. Now, you mentioned that you have done 3 already, is it?
Or no, we've been running them for 2 years.
Yeah. Oh, 2 years now. All right, so then 2 years,
we just
not
ran
2 workshops.
On Wednesday, do you want to talk about that?
Yes, I mean, definitely. It just ranges, really. We've done new baby workshops, then 6 to 12 month workshops. Toddler tame is what we did on Wednesday, toddler taming. We've done one for teens, talking to your child about sex, you know,
puberty,
and you know, so actually the age range is vast, and for each of the workshops, I mean, it's really, there is a high demand.
I see.
And it's also wonderful because it's a group of mums. We also have workshops for dads, which we've conducted over weekends, and for working mums. Come together, you know, talk, discuss, somebody who leads the workshop, have a cup of coffee, and it's great. And through the workshops as well, mums have got to know each other.
And connected,
which is helpful.
And great, that's a great way to network as well, isn't it?
And we've also learned a lot from the workshop, and the way we fine-tuned it, and we're still figuring it out in what works best for what, you know, kind of mum. And so that...